Today's communication network requires certain timing characteristics such as latency and determinism in order to maximize throughput and the number of nodes in the network. EtherCAT is an example of a widely used industrial Ethernet protocol, so in this demo I will show the new DP83826E and how it enables you to build your industrial Ethernet system supporting protocols like, for instance, EtherCAT. With round-tip latency of 210 nanoseconds and deterministic latency variation of plus minus 2 nanoseconds, the DP83826E enables you to reduce system response time and add extra nodes in a daisy chain network without increasing system size or cost. In this video, we are going to be using inclusive terminologies to describe EtherCAT functionality. An EtherCAT system consists of an EtherCAT host, which can be a backoff PLC using a TwinCAT programming interface and one or more clients. This system is programmed to send EtherCAT data from the host to client and back, in our case blinking LEDs on the client hardware. The EtherCAT client are using the DP83826E Ethernet PHY as hardware communication layer, and the client is showing no frame errors in the communication between host and client. Here a block diagram of the EtherCAT system is shown. This system consists of one host and two client devices using the DP83826E as the Ethernet PHY. This system setup has been used to test EMC immunity of the DP83826E device. In general, EtherCAT system has some basic requirements which the used PHY needs to correspond to. One of those requirements are link loss reaction time, which needs to be shorter than 15 microseconds. The DP83826E can do this faster than 10 microseconds. A second requirement is not using the energy efficient Ethernet, as it adds additional overhead on the plate payload. This feature is used to achieve the Energy Star label, but for the industrial Ethernet it is typically disabled. For more details on these requirements, see the EtherCAT client controller application note called Hardware Datasheet Section 1 Terminology. In addition to the basic requirements, there are some recommendations which improve your system performance. Some of the recommendations are mentioned here. The Ethernet PHY can support at least 120 meter cable instead of the standard 100 meter cable. Deterministic transmit and receive delays of the PHY, which means low latency and jitter performance of the PHY. Now, how can the user know if the PHY has low latency and jitter? Let's start with defining determinism, jitter, and latency. On this diagram, the different steps a PHY layer needs to perform to enable an Ethernet connection to transmit data is shown. These coding and decoding steps take time, which define the determinism and how the jitter and latency of the system, as shown in the example. Here it can be seen that the DP83826E only has 210 nanosecond maximum delay of the combined RX and TX delay of the PHY. The Ethernet PHY has improved ESD performance to easier conform to the IEC 61000-3-X EMC standards, and in general improve system performing, removing effects of noise in the system. To show the EMC performance, a new version of the TIDA00299 hardware was built, showing the DP83826E as an EtherCAT client, and this system was then tested according to the IEC 61000-4-4 fast transient burst standard. This setup was then tested as shown in the pictures, and the results are showing an excellent performance on the communication lines and good performance on the power port EFT tests. To get more information on EtherCAT system, please browse our resources such as the shown reference design or the application notes showing the importance of low latency in industrial networks, and further information on the DP83826E low latency Ethernet PHY. Even more resources can be found in the description to learn more about Ethernet systems.